From bright lights in Big City all the way to Tinseltown in Hollywood, California.
To here at the Ace Gallery for the Tyler Shields unveiling of his new gallery, Mouthful, here in Los Angeles, California.
I'm Johnny Alonzo.
I'm Al Soto, and you're watching
Click on This. Wow, okay, this is the first interview I have tonight. This is going to be a lot of fun. I'm at Tyler Shields' major premiere exclusive event here in Hollywood. What's your name, man?
My name is Panda. My name is Paul the Panda.
Paul the Panda. And to my right?
Pamela the Panda.
Pamela the Panda. Wicked. I think these are like for more things to come this evening. And I haven't even started drinking yet. This is kind of wild. More to you guys. Al, back to you.
I'm here with the beautiful and talented Brittany Snow. Hey, Brittany, how are you?
Good, thanks. How are you?
Fantastic. Great to be here. And first of all, have you shot with Tyler Shields before?
Yes, many, many times. I've known Tyler since I was 20. He shot me for a magazine, and then we just started shooting together about 6 years ago. I think we did three music videos together, and the first one we almost got arrested for arson. And that was the first time that I ever got in trouble with the law. We actually ran away from the cops because we were setting a car on fire, and that's when I realized that this guy was a little crazy, but it was awesome.
In the same vein as you, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, I was like, damn, I'm gonna get, arrested for arson. That's pretty cool, especially because I'm a really good person, I think. But it's cool to constantly like get to shoot with him, and he's always changing what he wants and getting more and more provocative. But you know, it's all in the sake of him just wanting to constantly push himself.
Brittany, tell us what upcoming films you have coming up. I know you have a film called Syrup and a few other big projects coming up.
Mm-hmm. I have a movie called Syrup, actually, that Tyler's in, and he's really good friends with Aaron Rappaport, the director, which is just a funny coincidence. And then also in Syrup is Shiloh Fernandez and Kellen Lutz, both of whom
are Amber Heard.
And Amber Heard, yeah. And we've all known Tyler for a really long time. It's a very weird coincidence. But then I have a movie called Pitch Perfect, which comes out in the fall next year, which is a musical. And then I have a movie called Petunia, and then a movie called Would You Rather, that are both independent movies. So
before we go, we got to talk about Love is Louder,
right?
Your organization that's actually a part of this gallery premiere party, right?
Yeah, Love is Louder is sponsoring the gallery opening, and it's a movement that I started with the Jed Foundation a year and a half ago to bring awareness to the voices that bring us down and promote like awareness to be happy and healthy and love each other. And I'm really glad that Tyler has shot a bunch of photos for us, and he's our main photographer for all of our press, and he wanted us to be a part of this, so we were very, very appreciative. Hi, I'm Brittany Snow, and you're watching Click on This.
Thanks, Al. Oh my God, this has been such a blast. I'm here in Hollywood on Wilshire Boulevard. This is one of the coolest times. It's a private event with Tyler Shields, and actually next to me, a very good friend of mine, fellow actor, kind of like a man of the hour here at this star-studded event. Andrew, how are you?
I'm great. It's so good to see you, Johnny.
Good to see you, man. How you been?
Very good. It's great to see Tyler's work, and you know, we've been working for years together.
Yeah.
So I think I'm around here somewhere.
You're in the other room. We actually just saw you against the wall.
Yeah, I'm somewhere. But anyway, yeah.
Now, I know you just finished up a film recently in Seattle.
Yeah,
is that correct? Tell us about it.
Well, I finished up a few films recently. One of them is Hansel and Gretel Black Forest, and that's got like Laura Flynn Boyle and Carrie Elwes and like, you know, Molly C. Quinn and the producer of Twilight, and that's coming out in September.
Good.
And then I just finished one called Small Time, which the creator of 24 directed,
right.
And that's got Bridget Moynihan,
yeah,
and Dean Norris from Breaking Bad and Christopher Maloney from Law and Order, and there's a few others, but
sure.
Yeah, so those are the two that I'm kind of real pumped about right now.
As you should be, and we're very excited. I know that you just had a film at South by Southwest, correct?
No, next year it's going to be.
Next year, okay.
Yeah, next year it's going to be.
And what is that one?
That's probably going to be Smiley, which is one I did. It's about Anonymous, the cyber hackers.
Good.
So, yeah, it's kind of a dark story about how they really, you know, twist this girl's mind, and they play these tricks on these people online and kind of drive them insane.
That's hot.
And I'm sure that I'm going to get hacked after it. I know my Facebook's going to get totally destroyed.
Let's talk about Tyler and you. I mean, okay, how did he meet you? Tell me about how he shot you.
We met through friends years ago, you know, when Tyler still used to go out to clubs. You know, we met through mutual friends, and we really just hit it off. And I consider him like one of my brothers. Like, he's a brother to me. I have like three guy friends that are like my brothers, and he's like family to me. I think he's one of the most prolific artists of our generation, to be honest. I know that sounds so pretentious to say, but I really do think so. And I know that his work comes with this like violence and darkness, but there is so much more behind it. There's a lot of meaning behind a lot of his work, you know, and if you really look into it, they have a lot of really interesting messages.
Sure.
And so, I don't know, I mean, he's my favorite artist of our generation, and I'm just so lucky that I get to work with him.
Well, I saw his work. I saw at your place, by the way. I saw some of the stuff he shot. Amazing black and whites. He's got some really, really rich colors. I'm very excited. Are you shooting with him anytime soon? Are you
going? Yeah, I shot with him about 3 weeks ago. I don't know if one of those is in here yet. We did a picture of me like falling in the rain. I can't tell you how we did it. I'm sworn to secrecy.
Not a word.
The thing is, if you go to Tyler and you work with him and he says no, like you say no, there's no point.
We're done.
We're done. There's no point. There's no point. You got to let him like soak you down, like throw blood on you. You just got to let him do what he wants.
He's the director. Let him do it. Go with his flow. Last thing, social networking. We want to find a website or any information on you. How do we find you, Andrew?
There's an official page on Facebook under my name. But then the best way to actually interact with me as a fan is on my Twitter, which is Andrew J. Allen. It's the letter J and then A-L-L-E-N. This is Andrew James Allen, and you're watching Click on This.
Back to you, Al.
Guys, we're here with Harry Shum Jr. of Glee.
Hey.
How are you, man?
I'm good. How are you?
We actually met several years ago. Baltimore, Maryland's my hometown.
Oh,
you
really?
Did Step Up back there. Step Up 1 and Step Up 2.
I did Step Up 2. Yes, it was a great experience. I loved the clam chowder, and I missed the crab
the crab cakes.
The crab cakes. Amazing crab cakes.
And Brianna Evigan, obviously a great friend of mine.
Yes.
But congratulations on all the success of Glee. Has gone beyond your expectation of what a hit it would be?
I mean, yeah, of course. You know, you always dream of hoping to, as an actor and a dancer, to get to a place where, you know, your work is recognized. But, you know, this is beyond what I ever thought it would come to. So it's great.
I mean, you're a dancer primarily. Did you have to learn how to sing to do some of your stuff?
Singing-wise, yeah, I did. I didn't come on the show knowing how to sing. I mean, I still feel like I don't. But at the same time, I worked really hard during the end of the second season and just made sure to hone the skills because I knew they were going to make me sing.
Yeah. Well, big changes, I guess, coming up with the upcoming season. How are they going to handle everybody graduating and coming back?
I don't know. I think it's going to all happen organically. You know, you love the characters. You fell in love with certain characters. And I think, you know, the writers are going to craft it in a way where you still get to see them periodically and follow their lives while still maintaining the whole choir room what is known with Glee, you know? So I think it'll be very interesting, and I think it'll be a new dynamic for season 4.
Absolutely. Any other projects, Harry, you'd like to promote? Any other feature films?
Right now, it's I have some on the table. I can't really talk about it yet. But right now, also, I'm working behind the scenes with this with John M. Chu with a D Studio.
You got to love John, man. He's
John
awesome.
Chu, yeah.
Don't forget G.I. Joe 2 coming out this summer.
As well.
Are you in that one?
No, I'm not, but I will be there supporting.
Of course, absolutely. Now, of course, you've actually shot with our buddy Tyler Shields.
Yeah, I have.
And you get quite aerial, I guess, in a lot of your shoots because you're quite limber yourself, yeah?
Yeah, and then he puts me on, and then he ends up, I was like, oh, I can do this. He's like, all right, well, we'll put you on fire. I'm like, okay. So he puts my shoes on fire, and that was the craziest thing I've done with him. But I have a great time, and obviously, he comes out with some
picture I saw with you with Tyler's pick that you actually look like you're flying or something. It's crazy.
Oh yes, jumping, and he put fire on the ground, and I had to jump up over it to make sure I don't get burnt. So I think I was more scared of the fire. That's how I got so high. This is Harry Shum Jr. and watching Click on This.
Guys, I'm here with the extremely talented and beautiful Nick Isabel. How are you, Nick?
Good. How are you?
Welcome to this Tyler Shields Mouthful event.
Thank you.
Now,
yes.
Have you actually shot with Tyler Shields yet?
I have. I've known Tyler for a really long time, actually. So, you know, we've had our random photo shoots all over the city, basically. So,
anything particularly provocative or controversial?
I think all of his stuff is pretty provocative and controversial, so yeah, I'd say.
Okay, very, very cool. Which we can check out on tylershields.com, of course.
Yes,
now, Nick, where might we have seen you in TV and film?
I think most recently I just did an episode of House, which...
Nice.
Yeah.
Did you make out with Olivia Wilde?
I did not. I actually got to bleed to death, though. That was a good portion.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I think Tyler would have been all over that, bleeding to death.
I totally called him. I was like, you have to watch this. You'll love it. So...
Tyler's thing with blood. What's going on with his obsession with blood?
I don't know. He's always been like that, so I have no idea.
And more to come here on Click On This. I'm Al Soto. Back to you, Johnny Alonso.
Thank you, Al. Look, as I said earlier, I'm sweating. I'm dripping. Look at this. Having a blast. He's not, because look at this, guys. He's got the best outfit on today. Justin, how are you, bro?
Good.
Good to see you.
All right, good to see you.
Wonderful, man. Look, first of all, how's everything going with you and your career?
It's going great, man. It was a very blessed year to be a part of the 90210 welcomed me a part of their family.
Yeah.
And they got picked up, you know, for the fifth season, so we'll see what happens with that.
Yeah.
Doing a film in a couple weeks, starting a project with that I can't say too much about, but with a very challenging project for me that I'm very excited about diving into.
Nice.
And yeah, I can't complain. I mean, everything's been so wonderful this year. It's been a very blessed year thus far, and we'll see how it goes.
If anybody wanted to find you online, do you have like your official website?
I don't, but I have Twitter, jdeely, DEELEY7.
Got that.
And yeah, I mean, that's the best way.
It's the best way.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, last thing, I mean, what else can we find you on TV? You got anything else coming up besides the 90210 stuff?
I mean, I got a couple films that will be released. One, Thrift Store Cowboy, which I did about a year and a half ago.
Nice.
It's, you know, a little country drama there.
Sure.
And also, I did a film called The Wicked. That will be out, probably into the summer. It's a horror film, if you're into the horror film scene. It was a lot of fun to shoot. And I'm also working on a web series that it started out just being a couple friends called Never Fade Away.
Right.
The second episode just got released.
Good.
It's called Mockingbird. Right. Features my character, so even more of a reason to watch it.
You heard it here first.
Exactly. But it started out with just some friends and having some fun and stuff, and it turned into something that's turning pretty special. So check it out.
I'm excited to hear that.
Hey, guys, I'm Justin Dealey, and you are watching Click On This.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
All right, guys. Well, we just interviewed Harrisham Jr., who we all know is a phenomenal dancer. We have two other amazing dancers here. We got Twitch over here.
What's going on, y'all? How y'all doing, man?
And who we have over here?
I'm Allison.
A lovely Allison here. Well, tell us about the upcoming season of So You Think You Can Dance. Both of you will be making an appearance, yeah?
Both of us will be returning to So You Think You Can Dance as All-Stars this season. Nigel just made a few new announcements about So You Think You Can Dance. There's actually going to be two winners this season, so that's very exciting. There'll be both a boy and a girl winner.
Wow, a male and a female winner. So are we looking at the winners right here?
Well, you know, if we could compete, you know, I don't even know if I can say maybe, but, you know, we're not competing this year. We were on past season. She was on season 2. I was on season 4, and we're on season 9 now. So we're just coming back to help whoever may win.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Any other changes expected this season? That's actually a big twist. That's different.
Very big twist. Yeah. Another change is that it's only one night a week. It used to be two nights.
Yeah, I read that.
Right, exactly. So it's only one night a week. So, you know, if you want to see it, you're going to have to tune in. You know, you can't wait for the next day and see what happened. You got to tune in and see what happens on that day. What's up, y'all? I'm Stephen Boss.
And I'm Allison Holker.
Watson, Click On This. Click On This.
More to come here, guys. Tyler Shields, gallery event.
Wow, star-studded event here in Hollywood. This is Johnny Alonso for Click On This. I'm with a very good friend, actually a mutual friend of mine, through Andrew, correct? Guys, this is Brett. How are you, bro?
How you doing, brother?
Good to see you.
You too, man.
Thank you. Everything's good.
Yeah, this is excellent.
Tell us, let's just cut to it, man. Let's talk about you.
Right.
You're an actor.
Absolutely.
What have you done lately? And just give us some of the highlights of your resume.
Actually, I just did an episode of Awake.
Nice.
The Jason Isaacs show.
Yeah.
And I've done over 25 national commercials, done a lot of guest spots and co-star roles. Tyler's got a movie coming up, so you'll be seeing a lot of me.
That's hot.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what is your connection with Tyler? Why are you here?
Actually, I've known Tyler over 10 years, man. I actually I got Tyler his first lighting kit for taking pictures.
Did you?
Yeah, we borrowed it.
You borrowed it?
Yeah. And so it was amazing. Yeah, we would go out late at night and shoot till, you know, the early morning.
Yeah.
And we just, you know, developed a friendship off that. And he's awesome. Just one of my best friends in the world.
No, he's a really cool guy.
Yeah, we know everything about each other.
That's good stuff.
Yeah, we're.
I love the moodiness of his photos. And I mean, just how, you know, eclectic and how jagged it can be. You know?
Yeah, he pulls a lot of raw emotion out of people. He's got a way of doing that through intense physical situations. You know, he's a master of that.
Sure.
Yeah, he's a smart guy.
Is it true that when he shoots you, it's whatever he says or there's no other way?
Yeah, and the thing is, you don't even question that because that's just what it is.
That's hot.
Like, you never, it doesn't even enter your mind. It's like, okay, that's what it is.
Really?
Yeah, it just happens. You never question, you just do it.
It's like, brilliant.
Did you see the one of me on fire? Yeah,
we just shot some B-roll.
Yeah, dude, crazy.
What was that like?
I have not been lit on fire that many times or even once, you know?
It was maybe by an ex-girlfriend, but other than that.
Yeah, she tried. I'm
right?
Fast. It was intense, man. It was wild. That brought the emotion out of me. I've never been lit on fire like that. I chased Francesca, you know?
Sure.
And the fire would, like, come over my ear and around my head, and it was intense, dude.
That's
wild. But if I didn't do it, I wouldn't be here talking to you, but I would have no idea.
Exactly.
You know? Like the fire hose one. We got sprayed with fire hoses in there. I don't know if you saw that.
No, I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, it's insane. That was the coldest day ever, and we're getting rain pelted with this freezing water. I was crying, dude. But it was okay.
Talk about method acting, right?
Yeah, right, exactly. She got the best of both of us. You got the fire and the water in there.
It's all there, you know?
Oh, it's crazy. It's wild, yeah.
If we wanted to find you on the social networking, man, you got any addresses? What do you got?
Yeah, I mean, you can go to brettlondon.com, sure. And then everything's Brett London. Twitter's Brett London. Yeah. Facebook's Brett London. Yeah. Everything's Brett London.
He's got that leading male name. It's just one of those actor names that you'll never forget.
I grabbed out my web real estate quick. Yeah. How's it going? I'm Brett London, and you're watching Click On This.
We're here at the Man of the Hour, guys. The one and the only Tyler Shields here at the Ace Gallery on Wilshire for the Mouthful Gallery
it's
opening.
A mouthful.
It literally is a mouthful. Now, tell us a little bit of what we're seeing here and which particular celebrities are we seeing here in this portfolio.
That is Demi Lovato, AJ McLean, Misha Barton. That's a large woman over there. It's just a mix of, you know, of all the people that I've shot and... there's a lot of Emma Roberts and a lot of Francesca Eastwood.
Of course. Getting crazy. How did you come up with the concept Mouthful?
You know, I started doing the mouth series, and in the giant, there's giant mouth prints everywhere. And basically, I just wanted people to be able to walk in through a mouth and kind of into the mind. And,
wow.
And then it just kind of escalated from there.
Wow, they say it's the dirtiest part of the body.
That's right. That's right.
All right. So, I mean, we're looking at ice. We're looking at jewelry. What are we looking at here?
These are diamonds on a heart. And then down there is glitter. We got everything. This is crazy, like a pop. It's Pop Rocks.
Okay.
Yeah.
Pop Rocks.
Yeah.
I remember Pop Rocks as a kid, actually.
Hard to shoot, though. All the stuff, the mouth stuff's not easy to shoot.
It's a
bitch to shoot, yeah.
I hear you actually starting a reality show. Can we talk about it?
Yeah, sure. What do you want to know? It's a reality show.
Yeah. When's it coming out? What is it involved?
Yeah. So it's called Mrs. Eastwood and Company. It airs Sunday nights at 10. And you'll see me do some pretty crazy shoots in it.
Wow.
We may or may not destroy some very expensive things. We may or may not set people and things on fire. Francesca may cry.
And it's usually not may not, it's usually may.
When I say we may, we will, absolutely. I just think contractually I'm obligated not to say that we will.
Of course.
But we will.
And, of course, that's starring Francesca Eastwood,
yes.
Who is the daughter of actor extraordinaire Clint Eastwood and living legend.
That's right. Nice guy, too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Wow. So you and Francesca have been actually a couple for quite a while, yeah?
Yeah, about almost 9 months now.
Wow.
She's the most amazing woman I've ever met.
She is amazing. She's certainly very stunning.
I'm contractually obligated to say that 3 times a day. By myself.
Now, I was talking to Brittany Snow a little earlier. She told me you actually had a part in her film Syrup coming up.
I did. I don't know what... I have my own infomercial in the movie, and I just improv the whole infomercial.
Okay.
So I basically showed up, and I said, all right, this is what I'm going to do. This is my infomercial. Mm-hmm. And they just rolled it, and I did it. And we did it like 10 times, and I went crazy. Mm-hmm. And then now the director of the movie wants me to play a leading role in his next movie.
Wow, leading role. Tyler Shields, the actor.
That's right. Wow. I'm really good at infomercials, apparently. I didn't know.
That's fantastic. Yeah. Now, the last event, I guess you had a collision. There was something crazy that happened in the end. What can we expect here at the Mouthful Gallery?
Oh, man. Well, there's some bunny rabbits running around.
I saw that.
They might be nude. There's some pandas. They might be nude. And maybe a live execution. You know, I don't know.
What?
I don't know. Maybe. You never know what's going to happen.
You never know. Wow. Holy shit. I just got ball checked by Tyler Shields. Holy shit.
You got to keep yourself in check. It stings in the stomach.
Luckily, there's a little bit on the side. But luckily, I'm not as well endowed as...
This is one of my favorite interviews.
I love this guy.
I'm Tyler Shields, and you're watching Click On This.
Click! We're here with the beautiful and talented Francesca Eastwood. How are you?
Hey, I'm good. I'm good.
Well, we have to stay and start up. Yes, the Eastwood name has a little ring to it. And like, can we let anyone know who your father is?
Oh, I don't think anyone knows who's my dad. You know, no one knows who he is.
We're talking about the actor extraordinaire, like icon in Hollywood and acting, Clint Eastwood. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it is awesome. He's a great dad.
Well, first of all, we got to talk about your reality show.
Yeah.
Premieres tomorrow, Sunday on E, right?
Yeah, it does. I hope you all watch. It's a great show. I'm super proud of it. I'm getting a little nervous now that it's 24 hours away. But
sure. Tell us about what we can see in the reality show. Is it about the family?
Yeah, it's definitely, you get definitely get an inside look on what it's like to be in part of my family. You know, my dad isn't in it too much, of course, but... Sure. But, you know, you see my relationship with my little sister, my stepmother. Tyler's in there a lot. We do a bunch of crazy stuff on the show, so it's very entertaining.
Of course, we are here for the Mouthful Gallery exhibit. Now, I was told you were actually one of the mouths, yeah?
I'm all the mouths.
You were actually all the mouths?
Every mouth, and then I'm that mouth that's the doorway, and then I'm all the mouths in there, too. So my mouth got a lot of action. I'm Francesca Eastwood, and you're watching Click On This.